Hello students, hope all of you are doing best of your health. So today we are starting our sixth semester, and in sixth semester we have a course named Managerial Accounting, which is 1+1 credit course. And today I'll be briefing about what we have to discuss under this course, what are the major things we will be studying. And this is a continuation of the, like, this course is not much difficult, this will be easy because you have learned similar accounting or inventory management courses in your past semesters. So this will be an easy course, this will not be a difficult one. And here you will come to understand what is bookkeeping, what is accountancy, what is how the accounts have to be maintained, what is journal, what is ledger, what is trial balance, how to make financial balances, balance sheet, financial, what are the financial accounts, what is a cash book. There are many n number of things that we will be learning in this course. So today in this introductory class, I'll be discussing about bookkeeping and accountancy. So bookkeeping and accountancy are two different terms, and you can say bookkeeping is a part of accountancy. Okay, so we'll see what is bookkeeping, what is accountancy, what is the definition, what is the characteristic, how both are different, all those things we will be discussing today in our class. Okay, so we will see what is the meaning or definition of bookkeeping. Bookkeeping is defined as the art of keeping permanent record of business transaction. Okay, that is recording the financial transaction or maintaining the records of financial transaction. So bookkeeping is simply maintaining the records. Okay, and it is been defined as bookkeeping as an art of recording business dealings in a set of books by J.R. Butleyboy, and R.N. Kartner have defined bookkeeping like, bookkeeping is a science and art of correctly recording in the books of accounts all those business transactions that result in transfer of money's worth. Okay, so you may have understood, the bookkeeping is simply, it is both an art and science at the same time. It is simply recording the transactions in the books of accounts, and which are in terms of money. If there is certain transactions of money involved, or if there is certain transactions in which exchange of money have taken place, those transactions have to be recorded. So bookkeeping is simply recording that transactions in a chronological order. Chronological order means the order of occurrence according to the time in which that have occurred. So bookkeeping is simply, if someone asks you what is the definition of bookkeeping, you have to define it as, bookkeeping is an art and science of correctly recording in the books of accounts all those business transactions. You have to mention all transactions which are resulting, which in which money is involved. Okay, all those business transactions that results in the transfer of money's worth. Okay, so let's see what are the features of bookkeeping. So once you understood what's the definition of bookkeeping, we will see what are the major features of bookkeeping. It is a process of recording business transaction. Second, monetary transactions are only recorded, only the transactions in which money is involved, that is recorded. The third point is, recording is made in a given set of book of accounts. There will be certain book of accounts in which the transactions will be recorded. Okay. Now, what's the fourth point? Record is prepared for a specific period but presented for future reference. Why we are maintaining all these records? Yes, we want to, like, for the future references, we need to maintain the records. And this bookkeeping is done for a particular period, maybe for 1 month, like, or 1 year. Like, bookkeeping is like, record will be maintained for a particular time period. And it is it varies from business to business, and varies from transaction to transaction, the kind of transaction. But it is always prepared, it's prepared for a specific period, and it is all it is used for the future reference purpose. And finally, it is an art of recording business transactions scientifically. So bookkeeping involves both science and art. So it is a both science and art. Okay, so I hope the features are clear to you. Now we will see what is accounting and how the accounting is different from bookkeeping. So we have seen what is bookkeeping. It is simply recording a transaction. Now we will see what is the definition of accounting. As per AICPA, the financial accounting is the art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner in terms of money transactions and events which are in part at least of financial character and interpreting the results thereof. Okay, so there are many terms involved in accounting. There is recording, then we have to classify, then summarizing, and finally that have to be interpreted so that we will get the results. So according to AICPA, accounting is defined as an art of recording, then classifying and summarizing in a significant manner in which the money, like all those transactions which are related to money, will be recorded, classified and summarized. Then those will be interpreted so that we will receive the results. Again, we will see another definition which is given by American Association of Accounting, AAA. They have defined accounting as a process of identifying, measuring and communicating economic information to permit informed judgments and decisions by users of the information. So this is all the same like the earlier definition. Like identifying means identifying certain transactions which are of economic in nature, that is money related transactions. So identifying the transactions in which money is involved, then measuring means how to classify, how to summarize all those things, and finally communicating is communicating the economic information to permit informed judgments and decisions by users of the information. So now it is clear what is the definition. Look, you may have understood what is bookkeeping and what is accounting. Okay, now we will check what are the features of accounting, how accounting is different from bookkeeping, that we will be seeing. So the first point is identifying the transaction and events. So we will be identifying certain transactions which are of economic nature or in which money related aspects are there. So we will be only recording the transactions. In accounts, we will be only recording or we will be only mentioning those transactions in which money is involved. Okay, so identifying the transactions and events. First, we have to identify which are the transactions in which money is money is involved. So second point is, it is art of recording business transaction. So once you have identified which are the transactions in which money is related, now you have to record those. Then it's art of classifying business transaction. Once you have recorded those business transactions, so business transactions which are of economic nature or money related, we will be recording that in the books of primary book. The primary book is termed as journal. Okay, and then it is the art of classifying. The third feature is the third step or the third feature of accounting is classifying the business transaction. In classifying means we will be classifying according to its nature, like maybe purchase or sales or maybe some other transactions. So we will be classifying those according to the nature. So it is involved we will be classifying according to the nature. And then fourth point is, the transactions are events of a business must be recorded in monetary terms, that those transactions that we are recording or classifying or summarizing, whatever be in accountancy, all the business transactions which are involved, in which money is involved, that will be only recorded. Next, it is the art of summarizing the financial transaction. Summarizing means we will be summarizing whether that is a profit, whether we incurred a loss, what was at the end of the year, what is the expenses incurred, what is the revenue generated. So all these things we will be summarizing. Okay, In summarizing, like we will be using trial balances or financial accounts may be also used for summarizing the business transaction or financial transaction. Next, it is the art of analysis and interpretation of these transactions. Okay, in accounting, the final way by which interpretation is done is the final accounts. Final accounts help us to know or identify whether this is a profit, whether we got a profit, or what is a revenue generated, what is the expenses incurred. So all these, like whether it is a profit or what is a loss. So all these interpretations will be prepared in accounting. So the balance sheet helps us to identify whether that is a profit or loss, what is expenses, what are the revenue generated. So it is an art of analysis and interpretation. Then finally, the results of such analysis must be communicated to the person who are to make decision. So these accounts are always maintained by the managers. Okay, so managers want to know, like if he is doing a business, what is the expenses, what is the revenue, what is the credit, what kind of what are the expenses that we have to make, what is the what kind of sales we have done, what are the purchases, what are the amount for which we have sold, what are the amount for which we have brought something. So all these things, and finally the final accounts, the balance sheet, the trial balance, the profit and loss account helps him, helps the entrepreneur or the business person to identify whether his organization is going in a positive way. In positive way, in the sense of economic terms, like whether it is a profitable thing or whether he should change certain strategies. So this accounting is helping him to identify the economic value of his business. So now we have understood what is bookkeeping, accounting, what is the definition of both, what are the major features. Now we'll see how different is bookkeeping and accounting. Okay, once you have understood what is both both separately, now we can see how they are different. Okay, now we will be differentiating according to certain points. Like first is based on the objective. As you can see, the object of bookkeeping is to prepare original books of accounts, trial balance, and to maintain systematic record of financial results. And when it comes to accounting, object of accounting is to record, classify, summarize, analyze, and interpret the business transactions and ascertain financial results, and to communicate to the various parties. So there is a very huge difference, where in the other side of the bookkeeping, only recording happens, and when it comes to the accounting, recording is there, then classifying, summarizing, analyzing, interpreting, and finally communicating that to the various parties. So based on the scope, bookkeeping has a very limited scope because it is just recording, and accounting, it is having wider scope because it offers wider scope because of recording, classifying, the features involved in accounting. So based on level of work, bookkeeping is restricted to the clerical work, and when it comes to the accounting, it is concerned with all levels of management. You know, in management there are three levels, and this is involved in all the three levels of management. And based on the mutual dependence point, the bookkeeping has to depend on accounting principles. In accounting, there are certain principles, there are certain concepts, and also that all things we will be discussing in the upcoming classes. So bookkeeping depends on accounting, or we can call bookkeeping is a part of accounting, and accounting has to depend on bookkeeping. Both they are interdependent. And when we see the fifth point, results of business, bookkeeping shows the net result and financial position. So the bookkeeping helps to showcase the net result and the financial position. When it comes to the accounting, it analyzes the operating and financial position of the business. It not only shows the financial position, also the operating position also. Okay. And sixth point, based on the stages, bookkeeping is a primary stage. As I said, it is just entering the records, and accounting is secondary stage because it involves recording and finally interpreting those features, interpretation of those things. And when it comes to the seventh, nature of the job, the job of bookkeeper is a routine kind. It is just entering the transaction, that is recording. And when it comes to accounting or accountancy, the job of accountant is analytical in nature. And based on the knowledge required to perform, the bookkeeper is not required to have higher level of knowledge, because it is a clerical kind. He or she just have to maintain a record, just have to enter the records based on the time of occurrence, that is chronological order. And when it comes to the accounts, the accountant must have higher level of knowledge. And the staff for performing the bookkeeping work performed by junior staffs, and accounting is performed by senior. So these are the major differences of bookkeeping and accounting. So I hope these are understood to you. So please do learn all those things. These are important for your exam purpose and also for your future. Okay, now we will see what is the accounting cycle. In accounting there is a cycle. As I said, we have seen the definition and the features. From there we have understood there is a cycle. It is a cyclical process wherein which identification of the transaction is the first thing that we do. Identification of the transaction. First we will be identifying the financial transaction. Financial transaction means the transaction in which money is involved. So first we will be identifying the transaction. Then we will be recording the transactions into the journal. Journal is the first book or the primary book in which the transactions are recorded. Okay, recorded according to the date of occurrence. We will be recording for the purchase, what money we have, what we have paid, accordingly what we purchased. So accordingly in journal we will be mentioning the recording, the what is the transaction happened. Once the we have recorded in the journal, then that will be posted into ledger. Okay, when we write in a journal or when we enter into a journal, when we enter certain details into a journal, we will be calling recording. And when we enter certain details from journal to ledger, we call that posting. Posting is a process by which we transfer the transactions from journal to ledger. Okay, in ledger we will be classifying, the classification happen. Once after classifying, then we will be summarizing. Summarizing happens in the book called trial balance. In trial balance, we will be having separate debit and credit balances. Debit, what are the incomings, what are the outgoing, what are the expenses, what are the revenue generated. So it will be, trial balance will be prepared. So from that, we can see what are the incomings, what are the outgoings, what are the payments that we made. It is clear from the preparation of trial balance, or it is a stage in which summarizing happen. Then passing to the passing of adjustment entries. There will be certain entries where for which we have to make certain adjustments. Okay, so that is and finally the preparation of the final accounts. The final accounts include trading account, P&L account. P&L account is profit and loss account, and balance sheet. So from the balance sheet we can understand what is the asset. There will be an asset side and there will be a liability side. So from that we will understand what is a gross profit, or what is our profit and what is a loss, whether our organization is running in a positive way, whether it is having a profit or whether it is having a loss. So I hope the accounting cycle is clear to you. First stage is identification of transaction, then recording of the transactions in journal, then posting, that is classification, posting into the ledger, then preparation of trial balance, that is summarizing, then passing adjustment entries, then finally the preparation of the final accounts. So I hope till now it is clear. So now we will see what are the objectives of accounting. So what are the major objectives? So we'll see. There are five major objectives. The first one is permanent record. Okay, because we maintain the records, we will be entering the transactions, classifying them, summarizing them, or interpreting or communicating it to the business parties. It act as a permanent record in which we can we can use it for the future references. So it act as a permanent record. Next is measurement of outcome. We can understand what is the outcome means, what is the revenue generated, what is the income generated, what are the expenses incurred. So it's measurement of outcome. We can see the credit worthiness also, the credit worthiness, the third point. And fourth, efficient use of resources. in an organization, once we check the records, the books of accounts, we can understand are we using the resources in a proper way, are we using the money in a proper way. So it helps, the maintaining the accounts helps us to use the, like, it helps to identify whether we are using the resources in an efficient way. And finally, the projections. Projections means whether we are in a positive side, we are moving in a profit side or low side. If we are moving in a low side, how to solve those problems and move in a positive way? What are the strategies we have to adopt? So these are the major objectives of accounting. First is permanent record. It acts as a permanent record. Measurement of outcome. Creditworthiness, efficient use of resources, and finally, the projections. Now we will discuss what are the branches of accounting. There are many different branches of accounting. For our academic purpose, we have to discuss on three main branches of accounting, that is financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting. Management is accounting is the managerial accounting, the same account, like as the same. So financial accounting, in which almost all the financial accounts, the financial statements will be included, and cost accounting, there will be cost calculation, the calculation of all kinds of cost will be included. We will be seeing what are the difference between these three, how it is different, how it is related to each other, we'll be seeing in the upcoming classes. This is all for today's class. We'll be discussing all the rest of the things in the upcoming classes. So I hope so far it is understood. So go and study all those things. If you feel any difficulty, get back to me. Thank you.